Hello everyone, and welcome to Sine of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and I want to show you this awesome method for dividing polynomials called synthetic division, which is an alternative to the traditional polynomial long division. Now, this method is great because it includes fewer steps and fewer calculations, which means less time and less writing are needed to perform a division, which means you can get to your answer quicker. I say this with caution though, because synthetic division works fantastically well when we divide by a polynomial of the form x minus b, where the coefficient of x is equal to 1. However, when we divide by a polynomial of the form ax minus b, where the coefficient of x is not equal to 1, then things get a little tricky. But more about that in a later video in this series. For now, let's keep things straightforward by looking at this example, which as you can see from the schisometer, is very mild. In order to help you better understand the parallels between synthetic division and long division, let's work through this example showing these two methods side by side, although I'm only going to talk about the synthetic division process. The way it works is by starting with a synthetic division symbol, which is in the shape of an L. And then, to the left of that synthetic division symbol, we put the value of x that makes the divisor equal to 0, assuming though that the divisor is of the form x minus b, which it is in this example. Here, the divisor is 0 only when x is equal to positive 3, and so we write positive 3 to the left of the synthetic division symbol. Now, we make sure that the terms of the dividend are written in descending order or descending powers of x. Descending just means from the highest exponent of x down to the lowest exponent of x, which is the case in this example. And then we scan the dividend to ensure that it includes all powers of x all the way from 3 down to 0, which is the case in this example. Now, this is important because if a dividend has missing powers of x, it will affect the synthetic division process, but more about that in the next video in this series. We take the coefficients of each of the terms in the dividend and we write them inside the synthetic division symbol at the top, placing them each in imaginary columns. To complete the setup, we take the 4 and we bring it down and we write it below the synthetic division symbol. And now we are ready to begin the synthetic division process, which only consists of 2 steps, unlike polynomial long division, which consists of 4 steps. In synthetic division, those steps are multiply and add. And that's it. Let me show you how it's done, and you'll see for yourself just how easy it is. Step 1, multiply. We take the 3 and we multiply it by the 4 in order to give us 12, which we write one column over to the right below the negative 10. And then step 2, add. Negative 10, add 12 gives us positive 2, which we write in the same column below the synthetic division symbol. At this stage, we have cycled through the steps once, and all we need to do is keep cycling through these steps until each of the columns is completely filled in. So let's do it. Step 1, multiply. We take 3 multiplied by 2, which gives us 6, which we put in the next column beneath the negative 9. Step 2, add. We take that negative 9, add 6, which gives us negative 3, which we write below the synthetic division symbol. And then back to step 1, multiply. We take that 3 and we multiply it by negative 3, which gives us negative 9, which we write in the next column beneath 14. And then step 2, add. We take that 14 and we add negative 9 in order to give us 5, which we write below the synthetic division symbol. Now that each of the columns is filled, we have completed the synthetic division process. What exactly do the numbers at the bottom of the synthetic division tell us? Well, they tell us the results of the division, that is, the quotient as well as the remainder. The first three numbers represent the coefficients of the quotient, while the last number represents the remainder. Bear with me for a minute here. Since each of the terms in the dividend is divided by x in the divisor of x minus 3, the degree of each of the corresponding terms in the quotient is always one less than that of the dividend, which means that the quotient is 4x squared plus 2x minus 3, while the remainder is 5. As always, we can write the results of this division in the same way that we have done in the past. And that's really all there is to synthetic division. And I'm sure you can see that it's a very quick and easy way to divide polynomials. Now, why don't you practice your synthetic division skills by trying out this problem and letting me know what your answer is in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, then please let me know. And if you want to step things up a notch, then be sure to check out the next video in this series. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.